Hello students, we have almost done 3-4 extra topics of our AP series. Now the next topic is other than the NCERT question, the RD Sharma questions is how to find out the missing 3 AP terms. It means whenever they will give us the that 3 terms are in AP, if the question start with 3 terms are in AP, 3 terms are in AP. If their question will start by this line that if the 3 terms are in AP और वो 3 terms आपको पता नहीं है, जैसे in the last class in the that question we that they have given the 3 terms 2x x plus 10 3x plus 2, in that they just have missing one value, that is x. Here they have not given any value of the AP terms, they have not given any value from the 3 terms. So here you have to assume the value yourself. Like if the age in the age questions, if the age is not given, how will we start the question? Let the Ram of how will we start the question? Let the age of Ram is equals to x, let the age of Shyam is equals to y. So similarly for the 3 terms AP, we are going to choose the AP like x, x plus 2. But for making the question more easy and comfortable, we will write let the terms are a minus b, a plus d. You can take d or b, any one letter. So whenever the question will be related by the 3 terms of an AP, you always let a minus d, a and a plus d. Why I have chosen these numbers only? Because for making the terms are in AP, we have to focus on the common difference also. We can't choose the terms like x, y, z because we have to maintain the common difference same. So here when you will subtract this term and this term, the common difference will be d, and when you will subtract these two terms, the common difference will be d. So it means yes, these terms are in AP. So whenever they will give the line that the 3 terms are in AP, your first line of the answer will be excuse me students, your first term of the answer will be let the terms are a minus d, a and a plus d. Dear students, so here they have given that the sum of the first three terms, some word we will read later on. 3 terms are in AP, these are the magical words that how we can find out that we have to start the question by letting that a minus d, a and a plus d. So I just write here let the terms are a minus d, a and a plus d. The 3 terms will be a minus d, a and a plus d. Now these terms are in AP and they have given sum of these 3 terms is 33. It means when you will add these 3 terms, the sum will be 33. So according to the question, sum of these 3 terms a minus d, a and a plus d, when I will add these old terms, the answer is 33. Here d and d cancel because one is plus sign and another one is of minus sign. 3a is equals to 33. So from here you can easily calculate the value of a, and the value of a will be 11. In 99% question, they always will give the first line that the sum of the first 3 terms of an AP is, means 33, 60, any number they will provide us. Whenever you will add these 3 numbers, your d and d will be cancelled and you can easily calculate the value of a in all the questions. Fine. Now the next information they can change according to the question. Here they have given if the product of, product means multiply, first and the third term. Write down according to second condition, first term into third term. Product of first and third, I have multiplied them, exceed the second term by 29. The product of first and third zyada hai kisse, second term se kitna zyada hai, 29. So I just have given 29 to the second term to make the equation to make the equality sign valid here. So first term into third term is equal to second term plus 29. They have already given this information in words. I just have changed it in a mathematical terms. So first term is a minus d, and the third term is a plus d is equals to second term is a, and 29 means 29. We all know that a minus b and a plus b is equals to a square minus b square. So here I can apply that identity. A square minus d square is equals to a plus 29. A plus 29. Now we have already calculated that our a is 11. We can put the value of a here. So it can be written as 11 square minus d square is equals to 11 plus 29. 11 square is 121 minus d square is equals to 11 plus 29. We know that it will be 40. So minus d square is equals to 40 minus 121 minus d square is equals to minus 81. Minus minus cancel here. I am just solving a quadratic equation here. D is equals to under the root 11, under root 81, and under root 81 will be not 9, it will be plus minus 9. So here we are getting two values of D, that is plus minus 9. So we will make two cases. Case 1, A is equals to 11 and D is equals to 9. So the terms are A minus D, A and A plus D. A is 11 minus 9, 11, 11 plus 9. 11 minus 9 is 2, then 11, then it will be 20. So this will be the first three terms of an AP. But if our D will be negative, case 2, when A is equals to 11 and D I have taken negative, then the terms will be A minus D, A, A plus D. Just put the values here, minus 9, 11, 11 plus minus 9. And they will be 11 plus 9, 11, 11 minus 9. And the answer will be 20, 11, 2. So whenever you go to answer two values of D, no need to calculate all the no need to create both the cases. What you can do, 2, 11, 20, then the reverse will be 20, 11 and 2. So this will be the answer for finding the three terms of an AP. Fine students, the question, more question about these series can be asked in a four terms are in AP, that we will discuss in our next class. That's all for today. I hope you understand it and try to solve more question related to the same word problems. Thank you, class.